Yes. Okay, I did. I saved it after I got outside. Dude, what? That's not hard, that's just cheap. I don't have Goblin Punch anymore. I really want Return Magic back, honestly. Every time, come bucket. Why, huh? Birdkill is still pretty good. Doo-doo-doo. Ability unlearned again, cool, whatever. Get more Peridos too. Which is cool, because I mean that increases Ramu's damage. Ramu. Get Goblin Punch. Give me Goblin Punch. Nope. I can't believe that. I was two fucking steps away from Kondo Fatigue. Fuck you, game. God, I was not expecting it to kill everyone. Like, straight up. What a bitch. Came with this way and there's still no mist at all. Yeah, what a weird shaped village. What's that thing? Looks like some sort of temple. All she ever thinks about is food. All you ever think about is girls. That's my favorite feels. My mind is filled with thoughts of you. Rally ho! Rally ho! Rally ho! Yay! You can't go in and see, unless you say the password. You can pass! You can pass if you want to! Rally ho yourself. This village has tasty munchies. Aye, that we do. Kondo Fatigue has aimed the most delicious nuts and berries in the world. I ken that's why folk are stealing our food. Apparently, it's like a ripper just, if you didn't pay for something, you're stealing. Ugh, you're the thief, eh, you know? You can't fool me, thief. My phonetic accent is just the best. Ah, here, tell there's a footin' in the sooth that's killing you, stir your body in the soul. Water is precious, nay, dude. But we shouldn't put our hopes in such fairy tales. Ah, heard there's a spring in the sooth. Okay, you'll be happy forever. Never mind. Doop, doop, doop. No one cares. Do I need to heal? I mean, I might as well. It may be hard, but it's just like my penis. The extremeness of the difficulty. You didn't see what just happened. Fucking, I got, my entire party just got owned by an entire, by one Thundara. Basically, all the enemies do a lot more damage. You have a lot less health. The only thing that's easier is steal rates. I have no singer, nothing to hide. I wonder who that could be. Steal rates are easier, but apart from that, you have, I mean, look at, I have less, I'm level 18 and I have less than 1,000 health. I'm doing about 250 damage. Come back in, William. Yeah, my strongest attack is, my strongest physical attack is like 250 at this point. Soon I'm gonna meet time to find a wife for me, William. No, lassie wants you, William Fetterman. Why, what's wrong with the sweet cider lass right here? Aye, that's a bonny lass in that. She's an awful small taysen to send to the sanctuary than you can. Look at her, she's a mickle bigger than ye. I'm not marrying anybody. Sanctuary. It is. It's a really, really fun version, a really, really fun mod, if you ask me. It can be a bit frustrating at times. Especially when you get your entire party gets owned at full health by one Thundara. Yeah, okay. Of course, and the good thing about emulators is state saving, so. Ah, what can you do for you? Yeah, we don't want potions because we're about to go to fucking Black Mage Village and we finally have high potions! It's so useful! You've been needing supplies. Sure, why not? Magic armlet. Oh, magic armlets. Nope, I don't want 11 of them. 3 of them will do. Lamia tiara. Oh shit, I forgot to put that on her, didn't I? Ritual hat. 2 of those. Magician cloak, give me 2 of those. Also, the other thing that's changed is, like, all the abilities have changed. For example, you now have this, like, Zidane now has the Sync of Restore, which, like, gives them, like, 5% of their health and mana back for every party member. It's kind of useful. You pretty much have to keep all of your party in the back row, otherwise they will die. I keep him in the front row just because of MP attack. And even then, I rarely use it. He's more of a healer in this version of the game. Okay, where the fuck am I going? I gotta find Cum Bucket. Oh, that's right, I gotta speak to the guys at the sanctuary. You're not allowed to pass, laddie! I won't. You can't pass. If you do not study, you shall not pass. Alright, so yeah, that's where I need to go. This game got a lot of extra hate. Actually, I never heard it got hate because it was difficult. I already got a lot of hate because of the art style. Whereas it was actually more faithful to the original Final Fantasies. Because everyone was like Final Fantasy VII and Final Fantasy VIII at the time. Everyone was like, oh, but it's not the same as those games. And I don't understand why that would be a point of contention. Because, I mean, of course it would be the same. Sis, I'm hungry! You just hadn't boiled ham. I did. It did not satisfy me. Oh, fuck you. Rally ho. Ah, it's a painty hat. It's one of the painty hats. Yeah, this game is pretty fucking ridiculous, if you ask me. This version, anyway. It's like, I just got level 4 holy for Quinna, and it costs 80 MP to use, and I only have 80 MP. Like, even with MP plus 10%, it's only like 88 MP. There's no limit glove, there's no farming grand dragons on disc one. There's no fucking... All those things that made the original so easy, gone. No fixed damage, no frog drop, no treasure hunt, treasure chest attack right from Zidane. The Soothiest Forest. We got to go to the Soothiest Forest. Alright, everyone's healed. Good, good, good. I mean, in the original game, I used to play with Vivi in the front row and just use him to attack because of how slow magic is. Now you pretty much rely on magic to keep you alive. like at all times. Yeah, it is pretty ridiculous when you need to keep Stainer in the back row just to survive. Original attack for this mod. Like, it uses an old animation, obviously, but... Ugh! The one person I didn't want knocked out there. Thankfully though, the mod author, I won't spoil it, but I took advantage of a small glitch, which is quite famous, and the mod author didn't think to remove, or didn't know how to remove, thankfully. Yeah, level up, excellent, cool. Damn, I'm running down to 2 frames a second again. Okay, now I should be alright. Where was I? Fairy earrings, take them off. Okay, you've learned everything. Oh shit, I just realized. Ability up. Animal vest. Okay, bronze vest. Magician cloak. Raises ice arm attack. Actually, that might be useful. Because the amount of I use Blizzara in the next area. But he still needs to learn ability up. Ooh, ritual hats. Yeah, that's it. Counter, insomniac, ritual hat. Now we have tiara. Magic armlet. Yeah, I don't really want to give her anything because she's about to leave the party. Silk robe. You'll wait to see some of the bosses later, because Soul Cage, for instance, is no longer undead and starts the battle with auto haste, auto reflect, and auto protect. Plus, all bosses are immune to every single status. So yeah, that should be fun. A yellow scarf. Okay, thanks, game. Oh yeah, Reflect Ring no longer has auto reflect. God, I really should... Bandit is useless, though. Bandit is just shit. Yeah, this'll be fine. There are owls, but there are no owls. Okay, I was going the right way. And up. And to the right. What do you mean, cannot find window? What are you doing, OBS? I forgot to heal, JD. I'm relying on summons just to do fucking damage. remember when... Not JD!
Oh my god, Gabe, why?
You are spending all of your money on potions and phoenix downs in this game. Frame rate! The emulator does not like this attack. Okay, game, now you're just taking the piss. Okay, game. You're very funny, game. We love you. Wow, how are you not dead yet? Oh, of course, now you're using White Wind, you bitch. I really should be using Bio with Vivi, not fucking Lizara. Oh well. Actually, I should be using Pandara because I've got the fucking thing on. Oh, pointy hat man, no! Level up, please! I need to level up! I need leveling up so badly. Ritual hat's fine. Ooh, wind damage reduced by 50%. That's actually really useless at this point. Ooh, I really think I should learn Rama before the next battle. I mean, it should be alright. Because I've only got like, what, 16, like 14 points to learn. And with ability up, I was saying like 7, so. Peridot. Is that really the only thing I have to learn for him? Okay. I'm done fucking around in the menu. Let's just heal. Nope, wrong way. No more that. Oh, shitting hell. I need leveling up. Oh, I'll be alright. Clowny, please! Someone attack Clowny! Oh, I have no way to do damage! Oh, just have no way to heal. Pointy Hat Man. There's two there! God, this is annoying. Okay. Whatever, we're almost done. Let's just get to Black Mage Village, please. The painty hate. I can't even say it, Alaconda. Brother and sister are the natural enemies. Like dwarves and black mages, or dwarves and humans, or dwarves and other dwarves. Damn dwarves, Yaru and Conde Petit! Humans! Hey, they could be dancers. It's not my fault you decide. You were about to fall through my legs, okay? Don't meow at me. Yeah. They were talking. There are others like me. Why would anyone build a village in the middle of a dying forest? Where's Pointy Hat Man? The humans are here! Pointy Hat Man! What's going on? Hey, they're all Pointy Hat Man! I love the Black Mage Village theme. Can I help her? Gladius! Yes! Yes, I have a Gladius! Finally! Shit. Anything useful? No, I got all this shit already. Oh my god, equip the Gladius, please! Look at it! I can use free energy now! I can do damage! Now I can do damage from the back row, cool. Nope, I didn't want to look that. I wanted to see if you had anything on the floor. And you don't. Yeah, so no more treasure hunter or whatever it's called, treasure chest. This is our village! You forced a little guy to guide you here, didn't you? This is all about you humans ever, yink about using us. What about Pointy Hat Man? Dude, Pointy Hat Man's our friend. I remember when I first met Pointy Hat Man, he set me on fire. Came here with a group of humans. Look into his eyes, he's aware, just like us. We escaped from Alexandria and the cargo ships. We wanted to live in a world where there are no humans. To find that, we had to cross the ocean. This is, what's the word? It's a cemetery. Right, a cemetery. A cemetery? So, underneath the ground. Yes, our friends are all buried under here. That's because I came here with Mr. 36. We escaped together. We had so many things to learn, it was very scary at first, but we helped each other. Then one day, Mr. 36 stopped moving. He just stopped, wouldn't move or say anything. My friend who knows other things said this was what death was, and we had to bury him. Mr. 36 is buried under the ground now. I don't understand why. He's going to come out again one day, right? When he does, I'm going to wash him off in the pond. What's he talking about? Was it a disease? Was he hurt? Tell me. Alright, I can't take him with it. I can't take her with me. Yay! Oh man, I bet Choco Egg tastes gorgeous. Like how I got revived there. You have to revive one health, otherwise it's game over. Welcome. High potions! My high potions! Give me all of the fucking high potions! Oh, like, maybe there was too many high potions. I'm gonna sell all my potions. Maybe that was like, one too many. Okay. Okay. Yeah, we don't need cotton robes at this point. How much of Peridot sell for? One. Oars? That's actually not bad, is it? Yeah. Let's go this way. Yay, I got the Virgo. Like, we don't want any humans to visit us, but let's build an inn anyway, just in case. Hey, pointy hat man, what's up with him? Became aware one day, each under different circumstances, became aware how? Do you remember being born? No, not really. It was the same with us. I just woke up one day, and there was a human body lying next to me. His body was covered in blood. It scared me. I didn't know what it meant. I ran as fast as I could. When I looked around, I was far away from the front line. There were many others like me, and we decided to escape together. We heard about this village after roaming around far. That's how I ended up here. Maybe our lifespan is limited. Many of our friends stopped moving recently. The ones that were reduced earlier stopped first. So how long have they been here? What's up, Cum Bucket? What is a joke? Is it scary? It's something funny, right, Cum Bucket? Yeah, a joke is like a name like Cum Bucket. Because she's a princess. But she still likes the D. Because even princesses need the D now and then. Dum 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 dum. Ooh, treasure. Ooh, that was not worth it. 800. Actually, I kinda do need gear after spending all my money on high potions. Now auto potion might actually be useful. Rune tooth. I need another missile dagger. Desert boots. I need a Lamia's tiara. I've already got a reflect wing. Already got some of them. Already got these. Already got that. Already got this. Ugh. Got wind. Okay, so I just need a missile dagger and Lamia tiara. Okay, cool. That shouldn't be too expensive. Don't know which way I'm going though. Damn it, I left my fucking bottle of wine up on the desk. Up on the. Damn. Why are there so many owls? Just for safe measure. I might need one later. Probably not, but what's this? Elixir, yay! Another one? No? Okay. trying to equip anything. Because even the Rune Tooth only... The Rune Tooth is slightly more powerful than the Gladius. But, I mean, it's just not worth equipping at this point. Where did Pointy Hat Man go? Where's he at, man? What's wrong? Nothing happened. This terrible village people. This village people eat terrible food. Oh, Pointy Hat Man. You got tired, right, Pointy Hat Man? We've been walking it all around non-stop. We should call it a day. I go to forest and look for food. Yeah, let's rest. You stop twitching. Maybe it's giving us some quite romantic time, Gumbucket. Come on, Cumbucket, he has a tail. Just imagine the things he can do with that. Pointy Hat Man's ever met black mages like himself before. What if they're being mean to him? Not saying nothing. Do you really think the people of this village gathered around to do something like that? You are fucking stupid sometimes, Cumbucket. In fact, half of your dialogue is naivete and stupidity. How about a bedtime story? Let's see. Once upon a time, there was a man. There was a man who didn't know where he came from. This man had longed to find his birthplace ever since he was a small child. His birthplace, a place only he remembered, a place he only remembered in his dreams. Why? He wanted to know more about himself, maybe. About his parents? The house where he was born? One day, the man left his home, the home of his adopted father, and went on a quest to find the answer. The only clue was a blue light he saw in his dreams. Yeah, he thought maybe it might be a place, a memory of his birthplace, an ocean, maybe. No, he never found it. How could he? His only clue was a colored light. So he went back to the home of his adopted father. What do you think his father did when he came home? Welcomed him home? Heck no, he beat the shit out of him! Baku believes in the tough love. This is the place I should call home. The man is still looking for his birthplace, but he already has a home. Maybe. It's the same for Pointy Hat Man, who's looking for a place to call home. I wonder if Pointy Hat Man will stay in this village. Who knows, that's for him to decide. Hello, nice to see you again. I wanted to ask you something. I was wondering how many people have, stopped, moving. But you already know what it is to live and die. You're asking about our friends who have died, not stopped. Some of our friends stopped functioning recently. I think our lifespan is limited. I suspect it's ever since the first one came to a stop. It varies a little, but most of us stopped moving 1 year after production. No. I haven't told anyone else about this. If I did, they'd feel the same way I do. I don't know. Fear? I don't want to stop. And maybe I want to run away from it all. But living in this village with everyone fills me with joy. The joy of living with them far outweighs the fear of death. Isn't it the same for you? Traveling with your friends gives your life meaning?
I don't know.
Yep. That's the one you're looking for. What's up, Cumbucket? Someone saw a silver dragon in the northwest part of the continent. Nice. Maybe we can find more about more. Go there. Maybe we can find out more if we go there. Maybe save my mother. Where's Pointy Hat Man?
Wait for me!
Everyone in the village asked me to go out and see the world for them. Look, my cat doesn't mind belly rubs. See, this is his belly, and he's just sitting here like this. How many cats like belly rubs? Ignore my headphone cable. You no leave me here, I starve! to Condé Petit and the Sanctuary. Level up, please, in the attack strat. Bird kick and come off. Insomniac, bright eyes. Okay, I think auto potion's good now because I've got only high potions. Level up, definitely. And I don't know. Beast killer, I guess. I don't know. I gotta test to see if Beast Killer is actually, like, affected by, like, free energy in his special attacks or whatever. Because if not, I might as well just put, like... Now you're falling off my lap. That's what you get for stretching. Kitty. Let's throw some shit at the... She's in the back row, so being tanked isn't that useful. Oh, excuse me. Check girls. Bright eyes, silly like emotion. Insomniac, I guess. Yeah, that's good. Loud mouth. Ability up. Silk Robe. One more battle and she'll learn that. Nowhere near to learn High Tide yet, but that's cool. Auto Potion, Absorb MP is so useful. Especially early game. You're fine. God, I need to put fucking Return Medic back on. I'm so close, I need it on. I'll just take ability up off. We don't need ability up at this point. Level up and ability up, that's fine. No, level up and... I forgot the save anyway. Oh, why did I steal? Get flare star. So worth the flare star MP. Ability up, cool. And now I can take off that because I've got it for Aiko. Definitely for Aiko. Thankfully, not that many things use fire around here. Fire is such a common thing to have on. Fire is such a common. Motion. Still one's best on, why not? Survival vest for you. Oops. Okay. Zara. You're fine. Okay. So anything you want to take off? Yeah, you're fine. Nothing there as usual. Opens the Chocograph menu. Abandoned Beach. where we are. Nope. Damn it. Nope. Come on. Where are you? Yeah, first time. Phoenix Pinion, Phoenix Down, Peridot, Diamond Glove. The Peridot will increase the strength of Rama's attacks. Apart from that. Let's save the game right here, just in case I get attacked in two steps. Fuck you. Fucking Zagunel, man. That means I've not defeated one Zagunel yet this game. That makes Zagunel harder than every single boss I fought. I mean, I guess I could use Bio. Oh, okay. I didn't know we could get behind that. I have a lot of fucking Mugnet shit. Say, I wanna get. Only those who have received the ceremony can pass. Speak to His Holiness. Didn't he ken where he is? No, you're not the Holiest Holiness. Where's His Holiness? I thought you'd be the fat guy. Usually religious people are fat. Speak to His Holiness. I didn't ken where he is. I know where he is, actually. I ken where he is. Right, oh, nope, I went past him. Hey, are you a holy guy? Aye, I'm Father David. Well, a priest has to worry about... yeah, we just want to get past this village. Oh, states that only those who undergo the ceremony can approach the sanctuary. If a man and a woman are blessed in holy union, they can leave sanctuary. It's so basically a wedding and a honeymoon. I didn't ken your words, but I think you understand. Hey, come back here, wanna get hitched? Okay. We have safe you young folk nowadays. We doing to 99 couples? I was worrying about the very thing. What's the ham? Only for 100 ceremony. Is everyone enjoying my terrible Scottish accent? Or terrible dwarven accent in this case. Phonetic dwarven. Spirits of the earth. Spirits of the moon. Watch over this man and woman as they begin their journey. Hey, hold on a second. What you said? This is a marriage. We're married. But that's... Dude, we're married, dude. It's not... In sickness and in health, have you the strength to carry you through the trials and the wisdom to follow the path? Come, Bucket. Now we're man and wife. Time for the kiss! Playing hard to get, eh? Happy feet. Now you need a new twins, something. To follow tradition, lad. Dude, it's not Vegas. It's not like Vegas when you're married in Vegas. You're married everywhere. No. Yeah, let's go see when you guys get married too. Yeah, that's it. In the meantime, come back and I can go announce our marriage. Have the strength to carry you through the trials. And the wisdom to follow the path. May the blessings of the heaven be as man and, I think woman. I'm so happy. Yeah, me too. Quina wanted some of that Vivi. She wanted the V. Rally ho, happy fit. Off to the sanctuary then. Aye. Rally ho, of course. Safe journey to the both of ye. Let us be off, my darling.
Thief!
Stop, thief!
Stop, thief!
Then you mean stoop, thief! This guy needs to shut the fuck up. Fucking. Hey, he just say fuck. And we kinda go to the father. Dude, they just said fuck in a Final Fantasy game. That's amazing. I never got that before. How did I never see that? Thief have nerve to steal food right in front of me. Hey. I bet everyone who's watching will be glad once we get past Conte Petit. What's wrong, Mug? Don't leave me here! You fucking bitch! Betrayed by my own trusted Moogle, this is how I meet my end. I'm gonna hurt you if I die here. Help! Don't eat me, it won't taste good. You heard her, Cloudy. Too bad. The Moogle that ran away, a very strange color. I go find it and eat it. Yeah. You're not hurt? Not a child, okay? I'm a kitty blue. You don't look any older than me, dude. I do have a name. Oh shit, what was I gonna name her? I didn't ask anyone in the chat for a name for Eiko. Okay. Let's call you. Horny. That's not even very clever. Introduce yourself before try addressing a lady. You introduce yourself. You got a problem? I'm Cumbucket. This is Pointy Hat Man. I'm JD. So, kiddo, where'd you steal from the village? He sounds just like Clowny. Did she really go chasing after the Moogle? Let's take her home, guys. Oh god, I'm tired. I guess it's better than nothing. I want to be a friend too. Oh yeah, they're friends. Dude, we're married! Fuck you, Cumbucket, you cock tease. Oh, okay, so the glitch I was talking about earlier. You notice Kiddo's HP is like 765 at level 18. It should be the same level as like Pointy Hatman's. Maybe slightly lower. So the glitch that I took advantage of was because her stats are linked to Marcus, I leveled up Marcus to level 99 and she got all of his stat boosts, which is cool. So I mean that's the end. I just leveled up Marcus while we were in the Alexandrian dungeon. That's the other thing I did off screen that I mentioned earlier. But anyway, here we go. Golem Flute, Sapphire, Fenra. Okay, definitely the first thing you want to learn is ability up. Boost is very important. This version comes with boost very early on, which is amazing. Loudmouth, Fire, Protect. Protect might be useful. Loudmouth is far more useful though. Antibody, Clear-Headed Silence. That Fenra definitely, so she can do some real damage. Wait, isn't there a way to get MP plus 10? Maybe not. I bet the M is 55, though. Oh, wait. Loudmouth. I'll take a potion every last time. Yeah, I'll go for a ability up at this point. So we'll put boost on, we'll put loudmouth on, we'll put ability up on. I guess we can put high tide on. I mean, I don't see why not. It's not going to be any different from clear head. It's not like anything around here does confuse. At least I don't think so. Right, You've got level up on. You've got level up on. You have level up on. You have auto potion on. You don't have auto potion on. Lermark. Yeah, nothing around here does silence, I don't think. If it does, I'll put Lermark back on. Anything else for three? No. Okay. And I think that's four. They had a confused flow. Yeah, this is cool. So come back as more of a summoner. Or is she more like a... No, yeah, she's a summoner with a secondary white mage, whereas Kiddo is a white mage with secondary summoner. Like, Comeback has more status attacks, whereas Kiddo will have more things like boost and chip. Kitty cam is always popular. Free energy. You can defend. You can use Blazara. Wow, 37 health. I'm glad you're here, dude. Stop attacking the same fucking person! Yeah, this is a really cool mod, actually. It's, like I said, it says in the thing, it says extreme difficulty. It changes loads of the abilities, it changes loads of the attacks, it changes loads of the damage rolls. Oh my god. Free energy should hit through a vanish, but I'm not sure. Okay, yeah, it does. Okay, good to know. Level up. Sweet. There aren't that many mods. One of the other mods I put on was an ATB bar mod, so it, like, makes the ATB bar move a lot faster. It doesn't, like, make the game any faster. Like, you're not faster than enemies, because enemies have ATB bars too. But it just makes them... It just reduces all that hang time. I remember how much I used to hate, like, sitting around in the menu... sitting around waiting for fucking... Yeah. Sitting around waiting for the ATB bar to fill up while nothing's happening. So, yeah, I've got rid of that, thankfully. Yay, I got a tent. It's cool, man. There are a few mods for this game around. But this is like the most famous one is Final Fantasy IX Unleashed. I've modded it slightly different myself. Like, to give my early game a bit of a boost, to make the streaming a bit more watchable. Because I would be dying every 5 minutes. Runner. Holy fucking balls, man. Auto potion. Oh, I'm so glad I've got fucking high potions again. I love Black Mage Village. Hello. Kitty, say hello to the people on stream. Why are you doing this to me, human? Hey, come back in. Was that an idol? I think so. Kiddo, can you summon magic too? Nice. Okay, so Kiddo can use Terrestrial Rage and kill Knowles in basically one hit. That's good to know. Yeah, she learned a bunch of shit too. Yeah, and this will be every single battle you'll do, you'll probably heal afterwards in this mod. Alright, level up. What did you learn? Life. You can learn life with something else, can't you? Ooh, I want that one. Can you please hurry up and learn? Motion. Made from mages. Blindstone shell. Okay, so no, there was something else that gave me life. What was it? Oh, there it is. No? Yeah. Fishusha. Yeah, okay, that's fine. I'm just gonna learn life quickly enough anyway. Loudmouth or Chemist? I guess Chemist would be more useful at this point. Just because there's nothing around here that does silence. Return magic. Okay. Let's just go. Yeah, this cat is fucking chill as fuck. I can do... And he'll just go back to sleep. And he'd be like, oh, he touched me. I'm going back to sleep. Thanks, buddy. Mugnet gives Sizuna a letter. From Mugnet to Sizuna, it's been 6 months since I started living in Conde Petit. The food here is great, and our people are really nice, Koopa. But the only thing I can't get used to is Rally Ho. Keep saying Rally Koopa. Okay. Do I need to tent? The answer is yes. If you have the opportunity to tent in this game, you fucking do it. Because it's the only way to get MP back. And you need MP. MP is like your main damage dealer. Like early game, it's gonna be like spells and MP attack from Zidane, because thankfully his very first weapon comes with a MP attack, like the dagger in this version. Because it got boost on, it's gonna do the long animation every single time. But it does like 1500 damage, so I can't complain too much. And 1700, so even better. I've also used it, I'm taking the slight advantage of the ATV weight trick. Yeah, boy. Yeah, the initial equipment is kind of useful in this version. Counter, rammer, loud map, excellent. Excellent, hey, we can finally put something decent on the cum bucket. Yeah, I might as well just put Protect on at this point. Fenra, High Tide. Alright, you're alright. Yep, that's fine. Free energy is gonna take 55 to learn. Shit. Life. Ah, Rama, that's what I wanted to change. Rouge. High time. Life. Kiora, Kiora, Kiora. Please, please, please. Give me Kiora. Shit. Close you up. Okay, cool. That's good. I love Final Fantasy IX, it's so cool.
What's that?
Oh wait, I just realized the Hill Gigas fight is next. And I do not want to be low on MP for that. Yeah, I'd be right. As long as, is that mist?
What? What is this? It appears to be blood. I hope this is not Chris's blood.
Okay, yeah. This is why I bought those desert boots. You're having desert boots on. You're putting desert boots on. You're putting desert boots on. You're good. You're alright, kiddo. Everyone else needs desert boots on. Because kiddo has the boosted stats from Marcus. Why has he got 8? Ah, shit, let's put distract on. Ah, mug, why not? Oh yeah, good level up taken off, because it doesn't really matter, because level up you don't get experience points for them, do you? You can only use Fenrir twice. I don't know whether or not I should go back and heal. Yeah, I'm gonna go back and 10. I want to be full health for fucking Helgigas, because it's such a tough battle. It's not as tough as Soul Cage. I'm really scared of Soul Cage, honestly. FF9 is definitely my favorite Final Fantasy game. Take a Vizara. Take a Rama. Take a free energy. And then just attack. No, I don't speedrun this game. This is just a casual playthrough. I can't do any speedruns at the moment. If you check the thing, I'm pointing. If you check the thing above the title, there's a link to my new build. I'm getting a new computer soon because this thing is dying, and it's dying hard. Like, I'm barely breaking 20 frames a second. I want to be able to stream in, like, decent quality, you know? And I want to be able to stream. It's cool. Don't worry about it, man. Okay, so... 58, 31... I want you to equip you with a... Yeah, Molten Racket. Oh, Silk Rope ability, yeah. I'm gonna give you... Yeah, no, you're right with Silk Rope. I was thinking about putting the Magician Cloak on him. But, that's not really gonna be helpful. I haven't built a computer in a decade, right? And I was so fucking... Like, there was so much new shit for me to learn. Because it's like, if you don't keep up with modern technology, you know, you wait 10 years and everything has changed. It's crazy how it happened. Ah! 2 steps and I got into a battle. Fantastic. That new computer cost me £566. But I'll be able to play games. I'll be able to play games, I'll be able to stream, and I'll be able to do it in high quality, and I'll be able to fucking... And I won't have streaming issues, and I'll be able to break 20 frames a second when I'm streaming. And I'll be able to fucking... I'll be able to... It won't look like I'm playing on a potato anymore. My potato will have evolved into mayonnaise. Yeah, I found it was really good because if there was any, because there's so many resources nowadays, it was really easy for me to like look it up. Like, I wasn't sure what like modular and non-modular meant for power supplies, and it turns out it just means like detachable cables and shit. I wasn't sure what ATX was. I had to look that up. I had to look loads of shit up. And the funny thing was, I was getting a compatibility issue with the build I've got up there, and it said, oh, my power supply, no, not my power supply, the cooling fan for the CPU was incompatible with my, tent. The cooling thing was incompatible with the case, which I thought was hilarious, because unless the cooling fan was, like, giant, I don't see why it would have a problem with the case. But, I don't know. Wow, I just wasted a fucking potion on one health, but a high potion on one point of health. I'm so good at this game. I'm so excited to get it, though. Alright, and save my game. Because fucking emulators are amazing. What the... Yay, it's Hilgigas! Dandle now! Dandle now, dandle now! Alright, I'll stop doing that to the cat now. Okay, summon! Fenrir! Skills! Steel! Alright, you can be for healing and you can focus. I want to focus the shit out of Pointy Cat Man. Come back and just be here for a healing. Although Cura would be a great help with this at this point. Well, I looked it up and the dimensions are actually smaller than my video card, so... The video card that I'm getting. So, I knew it was just a false flag. Yeah, I got the fairy flute! Nice! Alright, that's one focus. Yeah, cure. Oh shit, I didn't realize she had auto potion. Why am I not focusing? This thing has 8,000 health. Also, I didn't check to see if he stole anything. I was really tempted to buy GTX 970, but the price difference between a 970 and a 960 was like £100. And I really couldn't justify spending £100 just to get like 10 extra frames a second. Oh, I'm so glad I cured you. Pointy frame rate. Oh shit, dude. This is why we have auto potion. Unless it Kyurigas, because it's also got Kyuriga. Alright, I got the Phoenix down. Yeah, JD is my healer. JD and Cumbucket are my healers. Pointy Hat Man and Kiddo are my Never mind. Pointy Hat Man really can't do anything but focus. Phoenix down. Fiora. Probably should have done the ATB weight there, but never mind. I know in the speedrun, the Hill Gigas is a really tough boss. How many focuses is that? 4 or 5. This should be number 4. So one more should be good. Alright, everyone's back at full health, I think. Yes. Ooh, nice! Nice! Pointy Hat Man's got double! Oh, he's gonna kick some ass next. Oh, Pointy Hat Man, you beauty. Oh, it would help if I wasn't using ATB weight. There we go. Oh yeah, I love the art style in this game. Couldn't steal anything. I happen to know that it only has a silver fork at this point. Pointy Hat Man, use double black. I like Final Fantasy IX more than any other game, more than Final Fantasy VII or VIII, because it's more traditional, it's truer to the original games, in art style and story and setting, and things like that. How much damage is this doing? That was 4 focuses. Yeah, 4 focuses is cool. I couldn't steal another thing. The fairy flute was the important one to steal. Alright, we're still on double black, so that's still good. He'll die now. Oh shit. Maybe he won't die now. He should be down to about 2,000 health. Less than that, even. Restore, come on, baby. Bio. Rama. Damn, he's 1 point off. It should die now. Rama should definitely kill it. Yeah, I mean, I like 7, and I played a lot of 8. I don't necessarily like 8, but I did play it a lot as a kid. Mostly because I had such a small game library as a kid. Like, literally the only PlayStation games I had. The only console I had was a PlayStation. I did have a PC too, but didn't have many games for it. The only games I really had for PS1 were Spyro 2, Final Fantasy 7, and Final Fantasy 8, and a couple of, like, shitty fighting games like Masters of the Terrace Kasai. Confused, Silence, Locomotion, High Tide. Excellent! So, yeah. Nice. Alright, we got the Fairy Flute, which is a brilliant weapon for, Kiddo. Hey, that's not the way to the Aether, that's the way to the Aether Tree. It's weird in my place. I was only looking at the mountains. I thought it was called Sanctuary. That's what the Conde Petit people call it. They're backwards savages. Savages, savages. They're not like you and me, which means they must be evil. You Actually, no, you don't. Okay, cool. Okay. Put this shit back on. Body tap. Actually, yeah, I might as well start learning healer, because there's nothing else to learn at this point. If I put healer on her and then put Cura, that's what I wanted. Ability up is not that useful. Level up. Nug. Gladius. Bear with me a second. I'm just making sure these are all good. She learned a lot of shit, actually. Bandana. Oh, boost. Asuna haste wall. That's a very good haste. Ooh, haste. You tempting. Very tempting, but I don't know. I'm torn between her ability to boost Fenra or haste. I'm definitely gonna I'll stick with Fenra for now. Mug off and level up. Yeah, we're good. Cool. It depends. I mean, I like old console games and new PC games, I guess, and old PC games. It just depends on what console, I guess. Like, in my opinion, the greatest console was the PS2. In just sense of sheer game library, just because it had like the PS1 games as well. Fuck. Store. But, I mean, newer consoles, there's just no point, is there? Because nowadays, every single console game will eventually come out for PC. So that's why I bought myself a shit-hot PC, just so I can play shit-hot games. As well as being able to stream. I don't have any attacks. I can use slow. Wow. How much health do these things have? They have a lot of fucking health. And I still like keeping my PS2 around because, you know, because emulators just aren't quite as good. You know, the emulators still aren't perfect. Besides, I need a PS2 anyway for streaming. Because I can't speedrun on emulator for the rest of my life. I started off, of course, streaming with an emulator. Like, for PS1 games. Life. Don't talk to me about life. You learn life. Oh, never mind. God, I need to tent. I need to tent like yesterday. Wait, did I already pick up the moonstone? Oh, no, I didn't. Treasure! Ether. Yeah. Pick up. Ah! Bye. fucking shit. One Blizzara. Free energy. The only way I got to do damage at this point is fucking free energy. Give it a rest. I can't even use Return Magic at this point because everything just keeps one hit KOing Pointy Hat Man. I think these things have only got like 1400 health. Use it! If you're gonna attack someone, attack Cum Bucket! I haven't played the original FF9 in years. And I don't know, where are you from? Because if you're from Europe, if you're from America, then you don't know the pain of being a European gamer. I mean, at least I'm not Australian, I guess. Did you know anything about, like, PAL 60 and PAL and NTSC? Yeah, in a lot of PS1, PS2 games, because region locking, and because whoever decided to make TVs in Europe transmit at 50 hertz, whereas the ones in America and Asia transmit at 60 hertz, a lot of games run at 50 frames a second, whereas a lot of in Europe, whereas a lot of like American games run at 60 frames a second. It doesn't, you wouldn't think that make any difference, but it does. It makes a big difference because it actually means a lot of games run at 5/6 the speed of their American counterparts. It's ridiculous, honestly. I want to go back in time. If I was to go back in time, I would kick the guy in the balls who ever thought region locking was a good idea. Have you learned Fenrir yet, you fucking bitch? God, you're still like ages away. I want to learn Fenrir and Carbuncle before Soul Cage, because I have a strategy for Soul Cage. You live here as a pile of rubble. Maiden Sari, village of the lost summoners. Come on, come on, come on. Where's Mog, the fucking bitch? Mog, you fucking slut, get back here! I'm gonna fucking kill you for abandoning me! No, I'm not mad. I'm fucking livid! Oh well. Get to work, you guys. I'm gonna take a very, very short break. I need the toilet and I'm gonna grab myself a drink. I will be back in two shakes of a fist. Penguin says the kitty moves because he hates sitting on this chair without me. Thank you.
Oh my god.
Dude, she's like 6 years old. I mean, I'm pretty perverted, but that's just fucking weird.
Oh my god, I cannot open up this wine bottle.
Yeah, I got myself a drink. There's some strawberry wine for you. Gorgeous as always.
Very fucking alcoholic.
Vino. Yeah, my dad calls it that too. Actually, no, he called blackberry wine Vino. Whoa, you were about to fucking knock over my wine, you dick shit. Sit down. Nice. Did that Moogle go inside your dress? The kitty knocked over the cam, that's why the kitty cam looks weird. Come on. JD, come over here and sit with me. Damn, already down on our knees for you, JD. Go for it. What kind of mood do you like? What kind of islands do you like? What kind of moves do you like? What kind of girls do you like? I know you can stick that horn, kiddo, if you like it kinky. Come, bucket? Hey, dude, no, come on. One girl with a horn, a dude with a tail, and come, bucket. I can make some fanfiction out of that. If you know what I mean. Hey, are you jealous? Are you and Cumbucket really just friends? You guys are something more. We're a team! Just like me and Shitbag here. Pointy Hatman's also part of the team. Sort of like me and the Moogles. All clean, couple! Excuse me. So, what does Pointy Hatman have to say? What are his feelings? Does he have feelings? Mr. 288 told me to understand what it means. I understand what it means to live and die. But I don't really understand what it means to live and to die. Dude, does anyone understand what it means to live and die? This is really philosophical shit for a game, man. This is great. Where do we come from? Where do we go back? Do we go back there when we die? If that's what it means to live, I wonder where I came from. Where will I end up when I die? Why am I shaking? What is this that I'm feeling? Yeah, we're all gonna die one day, and then when the sun explodes and the earth crumbles to dust, we will become dust in the space again. Yes, we will, kitty cat.
Yes, we will.
What's up, pointy hat man? Get some rest, okay, PHM? What are Cumbucket's feelings? The only thing Cumbucket's feeling is... things. I don't even need to end that, finish that sentence. I read about them in a book once. I tried them, possessed the power to pull forth Eidolons. Eidolons. Knowing I had Eidolons inside me didn't bring me any joy. Mother imprisoned me, used the Eidolons she stole from me as tools of war. I thought I would kill my Eidolons if Kuju was going to use them for war. But now that they're gone, I feel like I've lost a piece of myself. Why am I thinking all this now? This must be the location. This must be... this place feels so familiar to me somehow. Welcome, kiddo. Possibly feed us. Kiddo's feelings. Kiddo wants to kill Bill. But here's where the real challenge begins. I don't think JD and Cumbucket are dating yet. Cumbucket has been slow to catch on to JD's moves. That means there's plenty of time for me to get between them. I mean, he is 16, she's 6, and in 10 years' time, she'll be 16, he'll be 26. That's not that bad of a difference, honestly. I've dated girls that are 10 years older and 10 years younger than me, so... oh, excuse me. Koopo, I'm sleepy. I really am. I'm gonna kick my speciality, rock-fisted potato. Even she even likes fisting. I love her already. That's delicious. How about some fish? Fresh fish tastes nice barbecued. Our favorite menu is rock-fisted potato stew and barbecued fist. Barbecued fist. Nope. It doesn't really matter which one goes fishing, I don't think. Grandpa, I don't want to be alone anymore. Help me do this right. It wasn't really, I mean, it's just a kid. I call everyone kiddo, honestly. It's not really a killable reference, it's just... I tend to just call young people kiddo. It's just a thing I say anyway. IRL. I feel so anxious. Dude, let's go see the Eidolon Wall. Oh, okay, I can't go see the Eidolon Wall yet. Oh, there was a treasure chest there? I didn't fucking see that. I thought there was a... did I pick up the Virgo? Whatever it is. Virgo or Libra. Where did I get this one? Libra was a perverse fellow, would always walk in the opposite direction of the sun. Must have picked it up. Oh, that's right, I've got to go through the kitchen. That's the problem when you play an old game that you played a long time ago. Sometimes you have trouble remembering, like, what you're actually supposed to do. Yeah, kiddo's kitchen. How many people do I need to cook for? There's me and JD, there's Pointy Hat Man. I guess I should cook for Cumbucket too. Come on, if her name means anything, she doesn't need feeding, she's already had plenty. Think again. Potato, potato, pumpkin bun, and lots of nuts. Should I put in that ugly if I found it? No. Get the water going, a good old shake of salt. Potato, potato, pumpkin bum, and now the shake of salt. Lots and lots of nuts. It's heavy! Hey, come back it. Let's go see the Alamo. There are at least two friendlies I can encounter at this area, and I need, for my strategy for Soul Cage, I need Aiko to have at least, or Kedo to have at least Carbuncle and Fenrelearn. So I don't know. We love Kedo. What? I must have missed what they were dialogue, because they said he, unless that was a miss, like a dialogue error. I was skipping to it too fast. The Eidolon Mall is a collection of paintings. The Summoner Tribe painted all these Eidolons they found during their research. These Eidolons all exist? Koopa. Yeah, this is a holy place for the Summoner Tribe. Lady Kiddo comes here every day to pray and burn incense for our ancestors. There's Atomos. There's Bahamut. Bahamut. What's wrong, Cumbucket? You'll get it back. I don't know most of these Eidolons. Did you hear? Some of the tribe honors nature. They named as well Gaia. They considered the Eidolons guardians of the planet. They attempted to become one with the nature due to some power of summon magic research. The tribe migrated to this location 500 years ago. But now... Kiddo's kitchen too, cool. I've got so much wine and alcohol because I make it myself. You probably already know this if you've seen my stream before. Pale, white hair, strange clothes! JD told me about you. You're a Kuja! JD, look for a man named Kuja. I call Clowny. Oh, you're gonna eat Mug. Mug don't come out when she's around. Yeah, this is great. This is all homemade. Like, here's some strawberry wine. I have a bottle here, which is cherry wine. It's gorgeous. Absolutely love cherry wine. Gonna make more of it next year. I'm really not sure why Kuja just doesn't kill Zidane, like, at the end of Disc 1. Like, he just flies off in his silver dragon. He says, oh, this kid can be a problem, and then just walks away. I'm not sure what his motivation was there. Unless he wanted him to kill Garland, but I don't know, it didn't really work out. Yeah, let's ask Clanny for advice. I know how many people live in this village. If JD is good, the Moogles and me make 11 people. It's good amount. These seeds are only strong enough to make food for 9 people. Well, it's not possible to make food for everyone. I teach you a very important lesson in cooking. Always make more than you need. Maybe more people show up. Maybe your guests very hungry. You're correct to make food for more than 10 people. Is this your only ingredient for stew? It's problem now with heat. How we get more heat? I ask Pointy Hat Man. Oh, yep. I mean, I don't know if you can see it, but let me just move the kitty cam just for you right now. If you look over here, I don't know how well you can see it in this light. You see the big white square? Underneath that is all my demijohns. I have 2 demijohns full of apple and mango cider, 2 demijohns full of blackberry wine, 2 demijohns full of slow wine, and a demijohn full of mead, elderflower mead. So I've got 7 on the go right now, 7 demijohns on the go right now. Plus, on top of the cover, I have 2 bottles of cherry wine all ready to drink. About 10 bottles of ginger wine and 9-ish bottles of elderflower wine. Also about 10 bottles of strawberry wine. But from earlier this year. I I have a lot of fucking alcohol, man. I used to like trade it and sell it, mostly trade it and send it overseas and shit. But my customer base dried up a while ago because the website I was using. Well, no, actually, I used it on Imgur, but like I can't seem to get a hold of my old customer base. Because my account keeps getting marked as spam by trolls. It's really annoying. And because Imgur is like, oh, if someone gets marked as spam, we automatically ghost them. Like, they don't do an investigation, they just fucking ghost people straight up. Kind of annoying, if you ask me. Because I could just go to anyone's account and flag them, and they get automatically ghosted. And you wouldn't know unless you knew what you were looking for. All my parents are dead and gone. I'm the last survivor of my tribe. I've been living here with the Moogles ever since my grandpa died last year. Oh, don't worry about me. I'm really happy here. 10 years ago, which is 4 years before I was born, a natural disaster struck the village, and even the survivors suffered a great deal. But my mum and dad fell in love, had a family. Not that I remember what they looked like, because they died when I was very young. I've been told that when I turn 60, my body builds a resistance to summon magic. I can leave the village with any Eidolon I want. And it's only a short time away, just like the small difference in our ages, JD. She wants the JD. You already know how to use summon magic, kiddo. Well, summoner can't choose an Eidolon until she has come of age. That's why I can't choose an Eidolon until I leave the village until I turn 16. Well, just keep training until then. How do you train? How? Well, it's our horn. We use our horns to communicate with Eidolons. How do you communicate with our horn, Cumbucket? I'm like a beautiful young heroine in turmoil, don't you think? You know why I'm here in this village? It was to meet you, JD, my beautiful shooting star. That's a line from Lord Avon's play, Wishing Upon a Star. Darn it, how did you know? Now this kiddo knows about the play. This place is far from the Miscontinent. Dude, you already know they migrated here 500 years ago. And it's already established that Lord Avon lived 500 years ago. Someone did ask you. It's so rude of you. Well, excuse me, princess! I'm gonna grab this first. No, I wanted the treasure chest. Damn it. Can you believe it? It's a first edition. I bet that... Dude, stick that shit on eBay. I tell you, if you ever found a first edition like Harry Potter 1, stick that shit on eBay. I saw one of those go for like £300 a couple years ago. Something on my face. Yeah, it's called a fucking horn, you weirdo. Oh wait, was JD talking then? I wasn't paying attention. Did you seal it, kiddo? So happened before I was born. They sealed an Eidolon that we failed to summon near the lift tree. It's our custom to seal a failed Eidolon that we summon it. We use the power of another Eidolon to seal it. Do you understand what that means? It means that a sealed Eidolon is so powerful it needs another one to trap it inside. Kiddo, will you make for sale for us? Come on. Do it. Just do it. Jesus, the stream today is just full of reference jokes. Yeah, treasure. I don't care about you, Humbucket. I got a phoenix pinion. And an ore. How... wonderful. Yeah, let's go to sleep.